मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघायते गिरी जत्कृपा तमहं वंदे श्रीगुरुदिनतारिणं मम ज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति स्वरूप दामोदर स्वामी नामिने नमो सद्भक्त मने मणिपुर उद्भवय च प्रभुपादलस्य दवाणी प्रचार निरताय ते पूज्य श्री गुरुवर्ग वंदित महाभावान्वित सदा पूर्वापर्य परंपरा प्रचलित प्राच्य प्रमूर्तकिते भक्तिर निर्मल निजरस निवृतम संरक्षकम सादरम वंदे श्री गुरुदेव नाथ शिराचार्य वर्जम निजम गुरुवाविष्ट सुप्रकम गुरुगणेराशीष संभूषितम चिंता चिंत समस्त भेद निपुणम सिरूप पंथानुगम गोविंद विदम उज्ज्वलम भरतनम भक्तन्वितम सुंदरम वंदे विश्व गुरुम च दिव्य भगवत प्रेम नहि बीजपदम अधुनत्व मंत्र गुरुन गुरुन भागवतार्थदान व्यासान जगत गुरु नत्व जय मुदिराये वृंदाये तुलसी दिव्याये प्रियाये केशवस्य च कृष्ण भक्ति पदे देवी सत्यवते नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि श्री गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। और हम्बल दंडवत प्रणाम टू ऑल द डिवोटीज ऑल द वैष्णवस बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ गुरु एंड गौरांगो बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ वैष्णवस we could able to do some humble service for their satisfaction. For last few sanghas, we are continuing reading of Mahaprabhu's teaching to Srila Sanatan Goswami. First, Mahaprabhu instructed him about Sambandha Gyan. Then, Mahaprabhu is elaborating the Abhideya Tattva to him. Before we begin our regular reading, anybody have any questions or comments to begin with? All right. Chaitanya Charitamrit Madhya Leela 22.23 Daivayasya Gunamai Mama Maya Durattaya प्रपद्यन्ते मायामेतं तरन्तिते। दिस डिवाइन एनर्जी ऑफ माइंड कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ थ्री मोड्स ऑफ मटेरियल नेचर इज डिफिकल्ट टू ओवरकम बट दोज हु हैव सरेंडर्ड ऑन टू मी कैन इजीली क्रॉस बियॉन्ड इट। परपोट दिस इज कोटेशन फ्रॉम भगवद गीता 7.14 दिस वेरी फेमस वर्स फ्रॉम भगवद गीता दैट जीवास बाय देयर ओन एफर्ट्स दे कैन नॉट ओवरकम माया। Only when they learn properly what is surrender and they establish themselves in that saranagati, then by the grace of Lord, they can overcome the illusion. Krishna Nityadas Jeeva Taha Bhuligala Eidose Mayatar Golae Bandila. The living entity is bound around the neck by the chain of Maya because he has forgotten that he is eternally a servant of Krishna. So we are becoming a dog of Kali or Maya. We have a belt of Kali or Maya around our neck. But Guru Vaishnav, they come, they give us some connection with the transcendental world and they give us another belt, a transcendental belt, as it's called Tulasi Mala, Kanti Mala. And then we represent ourselves as servant of Guru Vaishnav Bhagavan. Otherwise, we are being only having that rope around our neck of Maya. Forgetful to Krishna is the cause of that kind of false identity. Tate Krishna bhaje kare gurura sevan माया जाल छुटे पाए कृष्णेर चरण। इफ द कंडीशन सोल एंगेजेस इन द सर्विस ऑफ द लॉर्ड एंड साइमल्टेनियसली कैरीज आउट द ऑर्डर्स ऑफ हिज स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर एंड सर्व्स हिम ही कैन गेट आउट ऑफ द क्लचेस ऑफ माया एंड बिकम एलिजिबल फॉर शेल्टर एट कृष्णस लोटस फीट। उमा दीदी डू यू वांट टू रीड द परपोट?
यस महाराज दंडवत। It is fact that every living entity is eternally a servant of Krishna. This is forgotten due to the influence of Maya, which induce one to believe in material happiness. Being illusioned by Maya, one thinks that material happiness is the only disturbed object. This material consciousness is like a chain around the neck of the conditioned soul.
Desirable object.
Sorry, Maya.
Material happiness is the only desirable object.
Material consciousness, I can read.
Yes, this material consciousness, you can read from there.
This material consciousness is like a chain around the neck of the conditioned soul. As long as he bound to the conception, he cannot get out of Maya's clutches. However, if by Krishna's mercy he gets in touch with a bona fide spiritual master, abides by his order and serve him, engaging other conditional soul in the Lord's service, he then attains liberation and Lord's Sri Krishna shelter.
Thank you, Didi. चारी वर्णाश्रमी यदि कृष्ण नाई भजे स्वकर्म करिते से रौरवे पड़ी मजे. The followers of the वर्णाश्रम institution accept the regulative principles of the four social orders, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Sudra, and four spiritual orders, Brahmacharya, Grahastha, Vanaprastha and Sannyas. However, if one carries out the regulative principles of these orders but does not render transcendental service to Lord, to Krishna, he falls into hellish condition of material life. So this is very important. Chari varnashrami jodi Krishna nai bhaje, swakarma karite se raurava padi maje. Very famous. If you do only varnashram system, follow rules and regulations of that, but you are not practicing your constitutional position as servant of Krishna, then you have to go to a great hell called Rourav to go there. Okay, Devika Didi, can you read that translation, a purport?
Yes, Maharaj.
Thank you.
One may be a Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya or Sudra, or one may perfectly follow the spiritual principles of Brahmacharya, Grahastha, Vanaprastha and Sannyasya. But ultimately one falls into a hellish condition unless one becomes a devotee. Without developing one's dormant Krishna consciousness, one cannot be factually elevated. The regulative principles of Varnashram Dharma in themselves are insufficient for attainment of the higher perfection that is confirmed in the following two quotations from Srimad Bhagavatam, that is 11.5.2 and 3.
Thank you. Devika Devi. Mukha Bahur Padebhya Purusasya Sramehi Saha चत्वारो जाजनीरे वर्ण गुनेर विप्राध्य प्रथक. From the mouth of Brahma, the Brahmanical order has come into existence. Similarly, from his arms, the Kshatriyas have come. From his waist, the Vaishyas have come. And from his legs, the Sudras have come. Those four orders and their spiritual counterparts, Brahmacharya, Grahastha, Vanaprastha and Sannyas, combine to make human society complete. Ya esam purusam sakshad atma prabhavam iswaram na bhajantya avajanati stanad vrishtah patantya adha. If one simply maintains an official position in the four varnas and ashram, but does not worship the Supreme Lord Vishnu, he falls down from his puffed up position into a hellish condition. ज्ञानी जीवन मुक्त दास पाइनु करी मने वस्तुतः बुद्धि शुद्ध नहे कृष्ण भक्ति बिने. देयर आर मेनी फिलोसॉफिकल स्पेकुलेटर्स ज्ञानीस बिलोंगिंग टू मायावाद स्कूल हू कंसीडर देमसेल्फ लिबरेटेड एंड कॉल देमसेल्फ नारायण, बट देयर इंटेलिजेंस इज नॉट purified unless they engage in Krishna's devotional service. Yeyanni ravindaksa vimukta maninas tvai asta bhavad abhisuddha buddhayah aryoha krichrena parampadam tatah patantyadho अनाद्रत युष्मान अंग्रही. O lotus eyed one, those who think they are liberated in this life but do not render devotional service to you must be of impure intelligence. Although they accept service as severe austerities and penance and rise to spiritual position to impersonal Brahman realization, they fall down again because they neglect to worship your lotus feet. Purport. This verse is quoted from Srimad Bhagavatam 10.2.32. Many in India, they think highest achievement is liberation, mukti. Yeah? But Bhagavatam saying, you can fall down from that position also. That is not proper position. Krishna Surya Sama Maya Hoy Andakar Yaha Krishna Taha Nai Maya Radhikar. Krishna is compared to sunshine and Maya is compared to darkness. Wherever there is sunshine, there cannot be darkness. As soon as one takes to Krishna consciousness, the darkness of illusion, the influence of external energy will immediately vanish. Sumangala Didi, can you read the purport?
Dandavat Pranam Maharaj.
Dandavat.
In Srimad Bhagavatam 2.9.34, it is stated, Riti raham yata pratiyeta na pratiyeta chatmani tad vidyaya atmanu mayam yatha bhaso yatha tamaha. What appears to be truth without me is certainly my illusory energy. For nothing can exist without me. It is like a reflection of a real light in the shadows. For in the light, there are neither shadow nor reflections. Wherever there is light, there cannot be darkness. When a living entity becomes Krishna conscious, he is immediately relieved of all material lusty desires. Lusty desires and greed are associated with rajas and tamas, passion and darkness. When one becomes Krishna conscious, the modes of passion and darkness immediately vanish. And then the mode of goodness, sattva guna, remains. When one is situated in the mode of goodness, he can make spiritual advancement and understand things clearly. This position is not possible for everyone. When a person is Krishna conscious, he continuously hears about Krishna, think about him, worship him, and serve him as a devotee. If he remains in Krishna consciousness in this way, the darkness of Maya certainly will not be able to touch him.
Thank you, Sumangala Didi.
Thank you, Maharaj.
Bilaja manya yasya statum iksa pathe muamiya vimohita vikathane vikathanante mamaham iti durdeyaha. The external illusionary energy of Krishna, known as Maya, is always assumed to stand in front of Krishna, just as darkness is assumed to remain before the sunshine. However, the Maya bewilders unfortunate people who have no intelligence. Thus, they simply boast that this material world is theirs and that they are its enjoyers. Uma Didi, do you want to read the purport?
The entire world is bewildered because people are thinking, this is my land. America is mine. India is mine. Not knowing the real value of the life. People think that the material body and the land where it is produced are all in all. This is the basic principle behind nationalism, socialism, and communism. Such thinking, which simply bewilders the living being, is nothing but rascalism. It is due to the darkness of Maya. But as soon as one becomes Krishna consciousness, he is immediately relieved from such misconceptions. This verse is quoted from Srimad Bhagavatam 2.5.13. There is also another appropriate verse in Srimad Bhagavatam 2.7.47. Savata Prasannam Prasantam Saswata Prasantam Prati Bodha Abhayam Prati Bodha Matram Suddham Samaha Sad Asataha Paramatma Tatvam Sadbo Na Yatra Puru Karakaivana Kariyarto Maya Prayati Abhimukhe Cha Vijayamana Tadvayi Padam Bhagavata Paramamsa Punyasyo Brahmati Yad Vidur Ajasra Sukham Vishchokam. What is the realization of the absolute Brahmana is full of unlimited bliss without grief. That is certainly the ultimate cause of the supreme enjoyer. Ultimately pace of the supreme enjoyer, the personality of Godhead. He is the eternally divide of all disturbance, fearless, completely consciousness. As opposed to matter, uncontaminated and without distinctions. Is principle primeval cause of all. Cause of all causes and effect. In whom there is no sacrifice for productivity active and in whom the illusory energy does not stand. This verse was spoken by Lord Brahma when he was questioned by the great sage Narada. Narada was surprised to see the creator of the universe meditating for this indicated there might be someone greater than Lord Brahma. While answering the great sage Narada, Lord Brahma described the position of Maya and the bewildered living entities. This verse was spoken in the connection.
Thank you, Uma Didi. It is amazing that you are staying in London and you are not, so much well versed with all these words, but it shows that you are more absorbed in devotional practice than mixing with people. That shows very nice. कृष्ण तुमार हन यदि बोले एक बार माया बंद होते कृष्ण तारे करे पार One is immediately freed from the clutches of Maya if he seriously and sincerely says, My dear Lord Krishna, although I have forgotten you for so many long years in material world, today I am surrendering unto you. I am your sincere and serious servant. Please engage me in your service. Ek bar. Once if a living entity thinks like that, he can be saved. But they are not seriously thinking even once such type of thing. I am yours. Sakrit eva prapannayas. तवस्मिति च यच्छते अभयं सर्वदा तस्मै ददम्य एतद् वृतं मम इट इज माय भाव दैट इफ वन ओनली वंस सीरियसली सरेंडर्स ऑन टू मी सेइंग माय डियर लॉर्ड फ्रॉम दिस डे आई एम योर्स एंड यू एंड प्रेज टू मी फॉर करेज आई शैल इमीडिएटली अवार्ड करेज टू दैट पर्सन And he will always remain safe from that time on. This verse from the Ramayana, Yuddha Kanda 18.33 was spoken by Lord Ramachandra. We are not praying. We are thinking that we can do things. That is surrender, a prayer. A devotee is always praying. A prayerful mood. My Guru Maharaj Sipadma used to say, devotee must develop a prayerful mood. Prayerful mood. Always praying. We need to approach him with prayer. Bhukti mukti siddhikami subuddhi yadihai gadha gadha bhakti yoge tave krishnera Krishnero Bhajai. Due to bad association, the living entity desires material happiness, liberation, or merging into impersonal aspect of Lord. Or he engages in mystic yoga for material power. If such a person actually becomes intelligent, he takes to Krishna consciousness by engaging himself in intense devotional service to Lord Krishna. Good and bad association. That changes the individual entity. What kind of association we are taking, we become ultimately like that. So we have to be very careful. We are associating with karmi, jnani, yogi, or devotee, or what kind of devotee, all those things are very important. Akamaha sarva kamava moksha kama udara dhihi तिव्रेन भक्ति योगेन यजते पुरुषं परम whether one desires everything or nothing or whether he desires to merge into the existence of Lord he is intelligent only if he worships Lord Krishna the supreme personality of Godhead rendering transcendental loving service purport this is a verse from Srimad Bhagavatam 2.3.10 अन्य कामी यदि करे कृष्णेर भजन ना मागिते हो कृष्ण तारे देन स्वचरण इफ दोज हु डिजायर मटेरियल एंजॉयमेंट और मर्जिंग इनटू एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ एब्सोल्यूट ट्रूथ एंगेज इन लॉर्ड्स ट्रांसेंडेंटल लविंग सर्विस दे विल इमीडिएटली अटेन शेल्टर एट कृष्णस लोटस फीट ऑल्दो दे डिड नॉट आस्क फॉर इट कृष्णा इज देयर फॉर वेरी मर्सीफुल They are asking some garbage, some kind of illusion. But Krishna is giving them their feet. Take it. What is that feet? The association of his devotees is giving them. They are asking some garbage, nonsense things. But Krishna is giving them very intelligently, proper thing for their benefit. कृष्ण कहे आमा भजे मागे विषय सुख अमृत छाड़ी विष मांगे बड़ मूर्ख कृष्ण सेज इवन एंगेजेस इन माय ट्रांसेंडेंटल लविंग सर्विस बट एट द सेम टाइम वांट्स द ऑपुलेंस ऑफ मटेरियल एंजॉयमेंट ही इज वेरी वेरी फूलिश इंडीड ही जस्ट लाइक ए पर्सन हु गिव्स अप एम्ब्रोसिया टू ड्रिंक पॉइजन आमी विज्ञ एई मूर्ख विषय केने दिबा स्वचरणामृत दिया विषय भुलाइबा सिंस आई एम वेरी इंटेलिजेंट व्हाई शुड आई गिव दिस फूल मटेरियल प्रॉस्पेरिटी इनस्टेड आई शैल इंड्यूस हिम टू टेक द नेक्टर ऑफ शेल्टर ऑफ माय लोटस फीट एंड मेक हिम फॉरगेट इल्यूजनरी मटेरियल एंजॉयमेंट सो कृष्ण इज थिंकिंग this jivas can be foolish but I am not why should I give him something that he will damage himself I will give him my lotus feet association of my devotees and in that way I make him forget about that aspiration for poison Krishna says like that Devika Didi do you want to read this purport
yes Maharaj Those who are interested in material enjoyment are known as bhukti kami. One who is interested in merging into the effulgence of Brahman or perfecting the mystic yoga system is not a devotee at all. Devotees do not have such desires. However, if a kami, jnani or yogi karmi, Jnani or yogi somehow contacts a devotee and renders devotional service, Krishna immediately awards him love of God and gives him shelter at his lotus feet. Although he may have not had
he may have no idea
how to develop love of Krishna. If a person wants material profit from devotional service, Krishna condemns such materialistic desires. To desire material opulence while engaging in devotional service is foolish. Although the person may be foolish, Krishna begins all Krishna being all intelligent engages in his devotional service in such a way that he gradually forgets material opulence. The point is that we should not try to exchange loving service for material prosperity. If we are actually surrendered to the lotus feet of Krishna, our only desire should be to satisfy Krishna. That is pure Krishna consciousness. Surrender means not that we demand something from the Lord, but that we completely depend on His mercy. If Krishna likes, He may keep His devotees in poverty-stricken condition, or if He likes, He may keep him in an opulent position. The devotee should not be concerned in either case. He should simply be very serious about trying to satisfy the Lord by rendering His service.
But what the general people are doing in this world? They're taking a coconut to Lord, and what they're saying to Lord, give me son, give me job, give me money, give me this, do that. They're all doing all nonsense, actually. They're supposed to offer even a very simple thing, tulsi leaf and Ganges water, with love to Krishna, without any demand. Krishna, I want to please you. I want to satisfy you. Please engage me in your loving service, what pleases you. Please engage me in your devotee's service. That a devotee is thinking. But people are so foolish. They want to do some business lessons with Krishna. As if Krishna lacks any coconut. He is aspiring for your coconut. Aspiring for your money donation, 1,000 crore or whatever. He doesn't have one brick of Vaikuntha is such opulent, his entire world's all wealth cannot be compared to that. One brick of Vaikuntha. People are so foolish. They want to please Krishna or some business things. Krishna is only looking for your attitude, your love. What attitude you are approaching him? Satyam disatya artitam artito nrinam naivartha doyad punar artita yataha svayam vidhati bhajatam anichatam icha pidha pidhanam nija pada pallavam. Whenever Krishna is requested to fulfill one's desire, he undoubtedly does so, but he does not award anything which, after being enjoyed, will cause one to petition him again and again to fulfill further desires. But when one has other desires but engages in Lord's service, Krishna forcibly gives one shelter at his lotus feet, where one will forget all other desires. This is a quotation from Srimad Bhagavatam 5.19.27. Krishna sometimes does things very forcibly, for the good of, like mother, loving mother. Mother sometimes chastise the child, for the good of the child.
काम लगी कृष्ण भजे पाए कृष्ण रस काम छाड़ी दास होइते हाय अभिलाषे.
When someone engages in Lord Krishna devotional service for the satisfaction of the senses and instead acquires a taste for serving Krishna, he gives up his material desires and willingly offers him as an eternal servant of Krishna. They may come to Krishna with some other desires. By the grace of Krishna, they can change their desires and they can become actually devotees of Krishna. That's why they are higher to approach Krishna for some gain than those who are approaching demigods.
Stanabhilasi tapasvi stitoham tvam prap त्वान् देव मुनिन्द्र गुह्यं कचं विचिन्वन् अपि दिव्य रत्नं स्वमिन् कृतार्थोऽस्मि वर्णं नायचे.
When he was being blessed by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Dhruva Maharaj said, O my Lord, because I was seeking an opulent material position, I was performing severe types of penance and austerity. Now I have forgotten you, who are very difficult for the great demigods, saintly persons, and kings to attain. I was searching after a piece of glass, but instead I found a most valuable jewel. Therefore, I am so satisfied that I do not wish to ask any benediction from you. Purport. This verse is from Hari Bhakti Suddhodaya 7.28. We all know that Dhruva Maharaj went to Lord for kingdom. But when he seen the Lord's divine form, and he forgotten all those things. So there was some Karma Mishra Bhakti was there initially with Dhruva Maharaj. But Prahlad, from very beginning, is a pure devotee. So pure devotion starts from the platform of Prahlad Maharaj. Smarane Prahlad. But later on, Dhruva become also pure devotee because he changed his desires.
Samsara bhramite kono bhagyavan kehotare nadira prabhahe yana kashta lagetire.
The conditioned souls are wandering throughout the different planets of the universe, entering various species of life. By good fortune, one of these souls
may somehow or other be delivered from the ocean of nescience, just as one of the many big locks in a flowing river may by chance reach the bank. Sumangala Didi, do you want to read this purport? Your mic is muted.
Yes, Maharaj. Dandavat Pranam, Maharaj. There are unlimited conditioned souls who are bereft of Lord Krishna's service, not knowing how to cross the ocean of nescience. They are scattered by the waves of time and tide. However, some are fortunate to contact devotees, and by this contact, they are delivered from the ocean of nescience. Just as a log floating down a river accidentally washes upon the bank.
What is this nescience?
It's an ignorance, Maharaj.
Avidya. Ignorance. There is two types of knowledge in the Vedas. What are those? You know? What are the names?
Maharaj, para and apara.
Yes, very nice. Paravidya and aparavidya. Para means? What is the meaning of para?
It's a transcendental knowledge.
And apara?
Apara is material.
Yes. So Vedas gives two types of knowledge. Paravidya and aparavidya. Paravidya means that which is related to soul and the God. Relationships. And aparavidya, how to maintain the body in this world. Ayurveda, Dhanurveda, so many Vedas are there. So in Vedas exclusively don't reveal paravidya. Then you have to come to the conclusion of Veda, that is Vedanta. Vedanta talks about the transcendental knowledge, and the natural commentary of that Vedanta is Srimad Bhagavatam. But those who don't want to follow that type of knowledge and wants to depend on speculative knowledge like modern science, they are known as, that type of thing is known as mental speculation, nescience, avidya, ignorance. They don't have proper knowledge. Maivam mama dhammasyapi sayad eva chuta darsanam hariyam manah kala nadya kvachit tarati kaschana. Because I am so fallen, I shall never get a chance to see the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This was my false apprehension. Rather, by chance, a person as fallen as I am may get to see the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Although one is being carried away by the waves of the river of time, one may eventually reach the shore. Purport, this is a verse from Srimad Bhagavatam 10.38, was spoken by Akrura. Dandavat, Madhava Gopal Prabhu. Hare Krishna, Dandavat.
Dandavat Maharaj, Dandavat Maharaj.
Dandavat. How are you doing?
Everything good, Maharaj, here. Listening to you clan, Maharaj, everything good.
Very nice.
Beautiful clan, Maharaj.
Very nice. You are having tacos, Mexican tacos.
Only the soy, Maharaj. Huh? Only tacos and the soy.
Taco and soy, huh? Okay. Very nice. You're offering them to Lord, huh? Tacos?
Yeah, Maharaj.
Oh, good. Very nice. Actually, I went to this Texas, Dallas in US, and there are many Mexicans there. And unfortunately, there was no food available without onion garlic. And then they ordered from a restaurant and they bring some tacos without onion garlic. That's very nice, looks like Indian dish. Huh? And now it become very famous in US, this Mexican tacos, Taco Bells. Kono bhagye karo samsaro kshano mukha hai sadhu sanghe tabe krishne rati upajay. By good fortune, one becomes eligible to cross the ocean of nescience. And when one's term of material existence decreases, one may get an opportunity to associate with pure devotees. By such association, one's attraction to Krishna is awakened. Madhu Gopal Prabhu, can you read the purport? Your mic is muted.
Jai Maharaj, the purport. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur explained this point. It is Bhagavad fortune. There also in the accident something else in the scriptures. Devotional service and the pure activity are considered fortunate. Pure activities can be divided in the three in the categories. Which activity the Anke when one
pious, Krishna pious activities? Pious.
Pious activities that one Dharma Krishna conscience, a called Bhakti Omi Sukriti. Pious activities is the best material opulence in the called Bhagavad Sukriti. And the pious activities that enable the living entity in the margin in the existence of the supreme Kalama Sukriti. These last 2 hours, the pious activities are the actually the fortune. Pious activity fortune with the help and become Krishna conscious. The good fortune of the bhakti or mukti active only with it comes the contact with devotees. Be associated with the devotees, willing or the holy god. Only about devotional service and the one that makes Krishna conscious is our need.
Your English is like Spanish, huh? Sounds like Spanish, your English.
we have to
jump from one word to another word. but if you can read very slowly, then you can also, others can understand. Very nice. You are making an attempt. It's very good. Bhavo Pavargo. ब्रह्मा तो यद भवेज जनस्य तार्योच्युतो सत समागमः सत असंगमो यरिहि तदैव सद्गतो परावर्षे त्वयि जायते रतिः. ओ माय लॉर्ड, ओ इनफालिबल सुप्रीम पर्सन, when a person wandering throughout the universes becomes eligible for liberation from material existence, he gets an opportunity to associate with devotees. When he associates with devotees, his attraction for you is awakened. You are the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the highest goal of the topmost devotees, and the Lord of the universe. Purport. This is a quotation from Srimad Bhagavatam 10.51.53. Krishna jadi kripa kore kono bhagyavane guru antaryami rupe sikhai apone. Krishna is situated in everyone's heart as Chaitya Guru, the spiritual master within. When he is kind to some fortunate conditioned soul, he personally gives him lessons so he can progress in devotional service, instructing the person as supreme as super soul within the spiritual within and the spiritual master without. So is a Chaitya Guru. He can also come as Mahanta Guru. So Guru is there inside, outside, both ways. Guidance is there both inside and outside. And the matches.
Prabhu, the last sentence I didn't understand. What is he telling? Instructing the person as super soul within,
yes,
and the spiritual master without.
He gives guidance from within also. He gives that direction. Those who are sincere, they can understand it. He gives that. Even scientists sometimes getting that thing. You know, many times scientists, they could not able to understand one problem while they're working on there. Especially, you know, the benzene, structure of the benzene. The scientist was not able to know what is the structure. And he's seen in one dream, the snake is holding in a circle, the tail from the mouth. Then you understood, oh, that is the structure of the benzene. So Lord also gives what you want, inside also. So the guidance is inside, outside, both ways. Bahi Narsingha Hrudaye Narsingha Narsingha Madhim Saranam Prapadde. Outside, inside, Guru is there. Bahi Narsingha Hrudaye Narsingha Narsingha Madhim Saranam Prapadde. It's not that Krishna is not inside, only outside. Guru is also inside. Krishna is there and Guru is also there. Like that. So this is the last verse. Let us read and then give it for question and answer. Naiva payantya apachitim kavayas tavesa brahma yusapi kritam rudha mudaha samartaha yo antara bahistanu ritam asubham viduna vidunvan acharya chaitya vapusa swagatim vyanakti. Oh my Lord, transcendental poets and experts in spiritual science could not fully express their in-depthness to you, even if they were endowed with the prolonged life of Brahma. For you appear in two features, externally as Acharya and internally as the Super Soul, to deliver the embodied living being by directing him how to come to you. Purport. This is the verse from Srimad Bhagavatam 11.29.6. It was spoken by Uddhava Maharaja, Uddhava, after he had been instructed in yoga by Sri Krishna. So within and without, Lord is there, always. Sadhu Sangi Krishna Bhakti Sraddhaya Dihai Bhakti Phala Premahai Samsaray Khyai. By associating with devotees, one awakens his faith in devotional service to Krishna. Because of devotional service, one's dormant love for Krishna awakens and thus one's material conditioned existence come to an end. So we'll end our reading here. And you see in Abhidaya Tattva, Mahaprabhu is emphasizing more and more about the role of devotee in one's spiritual development. Devotee's association, that is Abhidaya Tattva. Without association of devotees, we cannot progress properly. Any questions or comments anybody have before we conclude today's Sangha?
Maharaj, one question. See, why do we read all these shastras like Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita? What generally, why do we read that?
Because our gurus ordered us to read that. For their satisfaction, we are reading it. And we are not worried about its result. We don't know what's its result. But gurus told us. And their purpose is there. So we are reading. They must be having their purpose in that. We don't put our purpose in front. Their purpose is supreme for us. They have some purpose. And their purpose, if fulfilled, then that is the highest fortune that we want to have. That somehow we could fulfill their desire.
See, what happens is, what I'm observing is, before coming to this Krishna consciousness, I had not read all this Bhagavata, Bhagavad Gita, in fact, Chaitanya Charitamrita only. Now I'm coming to know about it a little.
Mm-hmm.
I knew it was there, but anyway. But as the days goes on, like so many things I'm trying to get that knowledge from the internet, from the book, from Sadhu Sangha and all. Day by day, I'm getting so much information. A whole day I'll be engaged in that. But at the end of the day, I feel I don't know anything. And I feel...
Because you are only gathering the knowledge, but you are not engaging yourself in the service. Our goal is not to endlessly gain knowledge. Sat chit ananda. Sat chit ananda. Sat is eternal existence. Chit is knowledge, consciousness. But that is not the ultimate thing. There should be some joy, ananda. And that does not come from mere knowing. That comes through service. When one engages in service. And that comes when one takes shelter of guru. That process begins by taking shelter of guru, diksha. And learn to serve under the Vaishnava sadhu. We have to approach sadhu Vaishnava not to just gain knowledge, but to ask him, how can I serve you? What service I can do for you? That is the way. And by that, we can overcome our nescience, ignorance. Otherwise, that knowledge will be a fire, it burns us only. It's a fire, actually. Energy without direction is all dangerous, actually. So like that, endlessly gaining knowledge whole day, you will be crazy. Who told you to whole day gain knowledge? Why are you doing that? Who told you to do that?
No, it's just the more I read the Bhagavad Gita, more I like, because guru in the sense, Prabhupada is the guru.
What is your learning from Bhagavad Gita? If you are not learning to serve, then what is the meaning of reading Bhagavad Gita? No, Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Tadvidhi Panipatena Pariprasnena Sevaya Upadakshandite Jnanam Jnana Tattvas. You're not telling just knowledge you can know by reading. Have you become a professor just by reading books? Have you? Just by reading books you become? You have done so many things under different teachers. Then you come to that plane. The same thing in spiritual life also. It's not just you're reading books and you can become that. You have to serve under the devotees properly. You have to take diksha, initiation from guru. And then begin that process. Beginning of service is Hare Krishna chanting. The mala that is given by guru. A bona fide guru. It is not given by any rascal or anybody. It is given by a proper, pure Vaishnava. Seed must be given by a proper Vaishnava. And then continue your process of spiritual life by engaging yourself in service, nourishing that seed given by guru through Savan Kirtan, the water. So, first you have to take initiation. Are you ready for that? Or you want to be only take birth with the bodily conception? You have to begin your birth as, you know, the form of the soul. That is the beginning. Although Guru Padasana, beginning is through taking shelter of Guru. Shastra says that. Otherwise, what we know? Without the connection with the powerhouse, the fan is good, light is good, but it will not work. You have to take the connection. First connection. Adho Guru Padasra. Then the things will come to you properly. Otherwise, doing like that has no value. You understand? You are cultivating with plow so much the soil, but you don't want to put the seed there. What is the use? So many years you are just plowing and plowing the soil. Is there any use you will get from that? Oh, I plowed the land for thousands of years, but nothing happening. Now, that's a foolish thing. Nothing will happen there. You have no seed there. What will happen there? Oh, I'm plowing and plowing. What is the use? Put the seed there.
The chanting what I'm doing now is waste.
This all like, you know, that globule, homeopathic globule without medicine. You have to get the sound from a proper Vaishnav. The Vaikuntha sound is not ordinary sound. Sadhu Sanghe Krishna Naam E Matra Chai Samsar Jinite Aar Kono Vastu Na. In the association of sadhus, you get the Krishna Naam. And Asadhu Sanghe Bhai Krishna Naam Nai Hoy Naam Akhyar Bahire But a Naam Kabu Noi. In the improper association, we can chant the holy name, but that is not name proper. That is not name proper, is told in Chaitanya Charitamrita. So you have to begin first. Take the seed and begin from there. Then you can slowly, gradually make that seed germinate and grow and reach by penetrating different layers of senses, mind, intelligence, ego, individual consciousness, soul, paramatma, so many layers. Viraja, parapyam, so many layers it has to go up to reach by Golok Vrindavan. You have not yet begun that process. Just imagination is not devotion. It's a practical thing. It's not just imagination. No, that is not going to help. So take up that process. That is being taken up by all the great personalities. Even Lord himself has to take that. When he comes here, he also takes initiation, no? Lord Krishna take initiation, no? Mahaprabhu take initiation. Lord Ram take initiation to teach the world. And who are we? Are we so great? Oh no, we don't need it. So, if you like, we can arrange for that to begin. If you are willing to follow, chant the mala given by Guru, then we can arrange for that for you. Do you want it?
I want the initiation, but not immediately.
Yes, I can tell our Acharya Devi is there, Labhakti Nirmala Acharya Maharaj, and he can send you the chanting mala. Then through Skype or Zoom, we can arrange. He can instruct you about to get initiation. He can arrange. It's not so difficult. So many worldwide devotees are getting initiation. It's not a problem. Begin that process. Then you will see. If you don't join in the school and you are thinking how I can become PhD, you join first the school. Learn ABCD. All these things, learn. Then you can make sentence, word, or sentence, and all those things, and learn properly all these things. Then you progress. First is this. Adau Guru Padasraya. Taking shelter of Guru is the beginning. Is that okay? You think about it and let us know.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Madhu Gopal, what happened to your video? Hare Krishna, Madhu Gopal Prabhu. Are you there? Okay. I cannot get any response. Anybody have any other questions or comments before we conclude?
Dandavat. You told Devika Didi.
Yes.
That one is begin. But Acharya Maharaj told me you have to preach. What I want to preach? Because before initiation, what I can tell the other people, how I can preach.
Before initiation means? I don't understand.
No, no, because when you get Guru only chanting Mahamantra and everything.
Yes.
After Guru, yeah. Yes. Then what I can preach that one?
What you can preach?
Until come to Guru.
Uh-huh. What you can preach?
Yeah, until they are coming to Guru, before what I can preach, how I can preach them.
Yes, you tell them, you know, everywhere you need teacher, no? To learn anything, you need teacher. Without teacher, how you know anything? If children are not taught, they're left in forest and some robot is feeding them, giving some medicine. What they learn in that type of thing? They don't learn anything in that. If you bring such a grown-up person in that, such a person to the city of London or even Delhi or Calcutta, he don't relate to that. What is this? You will like, behave like an animal, actually. He don't know anything. So Guru is just, not just, you know, Guru is just Diksha Guru, but the Guru who gives us proper understanding of things, proper way of serving things, proper way of thinking, all those things. That is Krishna who is doing those things. It is Krishna who is coming as Diksha Guru to give us seed, or who give us, you know, instructions. Krishna is doing all those things. We don't see Guru as just a form. Is Krishna who is coming in that way, and inside also is there as Paramatma. Is Krishna is doing all those things. He's mystical. Everything is done in a mystic way, inconceivable way actually. Sometimes Guru also don't know what he is instructing to his disciple. Is Krishna is doing those things. Prabhupada many times told, have I written these things? Really? How I written this thing? He reading his own writing. Have I written these things? Lord Kishadas Babaji Maharaj, he told to Saraswati Thakur, I have nothing to do with your initiation. Mahaprabhu told me to give you initiation. I am giving that. I said, he told that much to him. Like this, something divine is going on. Nothing to do with this thing, this mundane world. However, there are so many imitators, so many rascals who have taken up that thing. They have to cheat people. They have a big guru business. They have done those things. And that is always there. Even in the time of Krishna, they are imitating Krishna, as Pandar Krishna. That is always there, actually. But the genuine thing, one has to accept the genuine thing. A guru is established by another guru. Guru is established by another guru. Like that. The process is in that way. It goes on. You understand? You have to preach all those things.
You want to
get rice as a crop. You know crop? You want to get rice crop and you don't have the seed. And how you get the crop? You have the land, okay. Oh, I have the land. I want to get rice. How can you get rice? You need the seed, no? And where you get that seed? Do not get it from you. From Guru you get the seed. Oh, I have the land. I am cultivating the land, but no rice is coming. Well, how it will come? To put the seed there.
Then directly I can tell them to take initiation?
Of course, why not? Why not? They can take initiation. If they like to take. Otherwise, they want to be like a karmis, but birth by, you know, bodily conception. That is up to them. If some have faith, and who can accept those things, then they have to take up these things. This is a preliminary requirement. This is not the highest thing. It's a joining of the school. Such a high thing is there. Initiation is not the end. It's the beginning. Initiation, the beginning. There are much higher things are there. But at least you have to come to school. You have to come to the school. You understand? Without coming to the school, you are thinking, I can become doctor, engineer. How can you become? First, write your name in the school and start that process. Then you will see where you are going. You are going to Vaikuntha or Vrindavan. Which direction you are going, that will be managed according to your attitude. How it can be. First, you join there. Brahmando Bhramite Bhramite Kono Bhagyavan Jeev Guru Krishna Prasade Pai Bhakti Lata Bij. Wandering so many Brahmandas, so many universes, one fortunate soul, by the mercy of Guru and Krishna, get the seed of devotional life. Guru Krishna Prasade Pai Bhakti Lata Bij, the seed that you plant during initiation, but then you have to take care of that. So many things are there to learn after initiation. All right? Anything yes, else? Lord. Anybody wants to ask? Today also there is a Sangha of Shiksha Gurudev. Srimad Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj, he holds every Saturday Sangha at 10:30 India time. Of course, it is late for you, but if you want to join, you are most welcome to join. It will be held on Google Talk. So I'm sending you the information here on the chat. You can save it. And you can join following that link is given there. 10:30 India time. So most welcome to join. Thank you very much for your association. You save it, this information, so it may be lost after this Sangha finishes. Bancha kalpata rubasya kripa sindhu bhayavacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo nama namah. Jai Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribraj Jagat Guru Srila Bhaktisiddhavandar Goswami Maharaj ki jai. Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribraj Jagat Guru Srila Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj ki jai. Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribraj Jagat Guru Srila Bhakti Yamalacharya Goswami Maharaj ki jai. Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribraj Jagat Guru Srila Bhakti Sundar Govindadev Goswami Maharaj ki jai. Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribraj Jagat Guru Srila Yesi Bhaktan Sai Prabhupada Ji Maharaj ki jai. Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribraj Jagat Guru Srila Bhakti Rakshasadev Goswami Maharaj ki jai. Bhagavan Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sastra Prabhupada Ji Maharaj ki jai. Mahabhagavat Srila Gaurakishore Baba Ji Maharaj ki jai. Sachidananda Bhakti Vinod Thakur ki jai. Vaishnava Sarvanand Jagannath Baba Ji Maharaj ki jai. Baladev Vidyabhushan Prabhu ki jai. Narottam Das Thakur ki jai. Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami Maharaj ki jai. Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasay ki jai. Rupanuga Guru Varga ki jai. Namacharya Haridas Thakur ki jai. Prem se bolo Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gaudiya Sivasadi Sri Gaur Bhaktavinda ki jai. Sarudamandar Ramdadi Bhaktavinda ki jai. Murari Gupta Prabhu ki jai. Saparsada Nityananda Prabhu ki jai. Saparsada Mahaprabhu ki jai. Bhakti Devi Vrinda Devi ki jai. Ganga Devi Jamuna Devi ki jai. Grantharaj Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. Chaitanya Charitamrita Chaitanya Bhagavat ki jai. Bhaktaraj Prahlad Maharaj ki jai. Shuddha Bhakti Vigna Vinashan Bhagavan Narasimhadev ki jai. Jai Shri Jagannath Baladev Subhadra Sudarshan Jeev ki jai. Jagannath Puri Dham ki jai. Mayapur Navadvip Dham ki jai. Aparaj Bhanjan Parsi Kuladip ki jai. Jai Shri Gupta Govardhan ki jai. Jai Shri Sadasi Gangadhar Jeev ki jai. Jai Shri Mathura Vrindavan Dham ki jai. Jai Shri Shyama Kund Radha Kund Giri Govardhan ki jai. Jai Shri Chaitanya Saraswat Math ki jai. Tadya Vishwapi Shakha Samuh ki jai. Shri Chaitanya Saraswat Institute ki jai. Jai Princeton Bhakti Vedanta Institute ki jai. Samaved Bhaktivinoda ki jai. Uma Didi ki jai. Devika Didi ki jai. Sumangala Didi ki jai. खोल करताल की जय हरि नाम संकीर्तन की जय निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि दंडवत एवरीवन
जय श्री भगवती निष्काम शांता महाराज की जय
जय देयर इज बलराम्स एपीरेंस डे कमिंग ऑन 3rd ऑफ दिस मंथ डे आफ्टर टुमारो सो यू आर ऑल यू कैन प्रिपेयर फॉर दैट यू कैन फास्ट अंटिल नून 12 o'clock एंड प्रिपेयर सम गुड ऑफरिंग फ्रॉम बलदेव And that will be very nice. Baladev is Guru Tattva. So you can do some service. That day will be nice. Dandavat.
Dandavat. Dandavat.